Dear viewers, welcome to the course Data Structures and Applications. This is session 7 of module 3. Contents are delivered by myself, Satisha MS, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Canara Engineering College, Bantwal, Mangaluru. This session covers the double linked list concept, continuation of double linked list concept, what you have studied in the previous session. In this session, we are going to discuss about how to delete an element from the double linked list, and we conclude this module with the concept of garbage collection. Deletion from our double linked list. The return type of this function is void, because this function is not returning anything. It just delete a node from the double linked list. Name of the function is ddelete, that is double linked list delete. This function takes two parameters, node pointer, node. First parameter is node. This is pointing to the header node of the linked list. The variable node is pointing to the header node of the linked list. And this function also receive the address of a node you wanted to delete, that is pointed by the variable delete is pointing to the node which you wanted to delete. Node is a pointer pointing to the header node of the double linked list. Delete is a variable, it is pointing to the node which you wanted to delete. So first statement is, if node is equal to deleted, means if the node you wanted to delete is a header node, then deletion of a header node is not permitted. It's not possible to delete a header node from the linked list, because as I already explained in the previous sections, that header node contains the important information like length of the node, number of nodes in the list, some special informations can be stored in the header node of a linked list. So therefore, generally you are not permitted to delete a header node from the linked list. So that's why first we will check whether the node you wanted to delete or the node you are trying to delete is header node or not. If it is a header node, then deletion of a header node is not permitted. If the node you are trying to delete is not header node, then delete a node pointed by the variable deleted. So let us take one simple example. Node with 3 or 4 nodes. So here this is the double linked list which consists of 4 nodes. Let us assume that there are 4 nodes in the given double linked list. From that you wanted to delete one node. So here the right link field is pointing to the next node and left link field is pointing to the previous node. So same way here also the right link field is pointing to the next node and left link field of this node is pointing to its previous node. So here it is like this. And as I already mentioned that the right link field of this node is pointing to here. And left link field of this is pointing to here. This is about double linked list. This you have already studied with a header node. Let us assume that you wanted to delete a node pointed by a variable deleted. This circular double linked list. So here this is the node you wanted to delete. This is pointed by deleted. And assume that this is a header node. and this is pointed by node. This is pointed by node. So now I will check whether node is equal to deleted. In our case, node is equal to deleted is not true, because node is pointing to this node and deleted is pointing to this node. So therefore it goes to the else part. So in the else part, you have a statement to deleted a node pointed by deleted. You wanted to delete this node. How can I delete this node? You know, after deleting this node, so you have to store the address of this node. You know that this is the node you wanted to delete. After deleting this node, so the left link field of this node is address of this node, and right link field of this node is the address of this node. So where the address of this node is available, the address of this node is available in the right link field of node deleted, right link field of node deleted, and where the address of this node is available in the left link field of this node. So that you have to take. So you have to store the address of this node in the right link field of this node, and address of this node in the left link field of this node. That you have to do. For that, you have to execute these instructions. So we'll see how these instructions will work. See, deleted of L link of R link. So deleted of L link means this one. Deleted of L link means this point. This point. What you have in this part of a node? In this part of a node, you have a address of this node. Address of this node. So of R link means the this portion. This portion. So say for example, if the address of this node is 200. Address of this node is 200. That 200 is available here. The 200 is available here. This is the address. So deleted of L link means 200. Deleted of L link is having 200. Of R link means R link of 200. So to the R link of 200, you are going to store the deleted of R link. What you have in the deleted of R link? So you have an address of this node. In the R link of the node you wanted to delete is having an address of this node that you are going to store. After executing this statement, this link is removed. That means this link is get existed. So here it is pointing to this node. Then next, assume that the base address of this node is say 300. This 300 is available here in the right link field of the node you are trying to delete, contain the value 300. So deleted of R link means 300. Deleted of R link means 300. Of L link means left link field of 300. What's the left link field of 300? Here you have address of the node you are trying to delete. So but after deleting a node, you have to store this. That is 200 you wanted to store here. So is equal to deleted of L link. What is the value of L link? Value of L link is 200. That is going to be stored here. So soon after you store a value 200 in the left link field of this node, so then here this is pointing to this node. That is, this link is removed and this link is pointing to this node. So now then after that, free deleted means you have to delete this node. Now this node is deleted. So after this node, you have this node, that is the node with the address 200. And next, this is the node comes in the linked list, that is the node with the address 300. So this is how you can delete a node in the doubly linked list. So next, it is garbage collection. We'll see what you mean by garbage collection. What's the use of garbage collection in the programming language? So in computer science, garbage collection is a type of memory management. It's a say built-in function. It is used to manage the memory. It automatically cleans up unused objects and pointers in a memory, allowing the resources to be used again. Some programming language have built-in garbage collection, while others requires custom functions to manage unused memory. So this explanation can be clearly understood by looking at the diagram in the next slide. So this diagram shows the garbage collection of a programming language. So let us assume that you are executing some programs in a computer. Executing the programs in the computer, you know, when the program is executing, program requests the data. So the required data are going to be stored inside a computer memory. For that you need a space. So space required for your program has been taken from this free space. This is the free space available for your program. It will takes the memory from this free space and store the required data, then execute the program. During the execution or after the execution, some of the space which is allocated for your program, it gets deleted. So let us assume that this is the deleted space. This space is no longer required for your program. So the garbage collector will keep track of these free spaces, collect all these free spaces, periodically collect all these free spaces and made it available for the next program or the same program. So when the garbage collector will collect all these free spaces, when this free space is no longer required for your program and the space is not available for the program to execute, or you can say the very less space is available. There are two cases where the garbage collector is going to collect these free spaces or deleted spaces. So case number one is very less amount of memory is available for the program, or the free space is not at all available. In that case, the garbage collector is get executed and it will check all the deleted spaces or a garbage space and collect all this garbage space and give it to the availability list. So and then your program can take that space from the availability list and execute the program or continue with the execution of the program. So this is going to be happened automatically most of the case. So this is the built-in function or a program. Garbage collection is a built-in program. It will collect all the deleted spaces and give it to the availability list. So this way the garbage collector works in the computer program. As usual, these contents of the presentation has been taken from these two textbooks. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.